And and he specifically described him as being so compassionate of the mu'mineen and so merciful on them. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله وأحذركم ونفسي من عصيانه ومخالفة أمره لزوما لقوله الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وكذلك في قول الحق تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا اتقوا الله فإن زلزلت الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. I begin by encouraging you and myself first of all to fulfill the commands of Allah. And I warn you and myself first of all from disobeying Him. According to Him telling us in the Quran, O you who believe, fear Allah, the weaker should be feared, and they not accept the state of Islam. And for Him also telling us in the Quran, O mankind, fear your Lord. The one who created you from one soul, I created its mate from it, and created from them so many men and women. And fear your Lord, by whose name you demand your mutual rights from one another. And fear your Lord, by observing the right of you who brought my relatives, your Rahim. Fear your Lord, as the shaking of the hour is so horrible. When you see the pregnant dropping her load, and the nursing mother too busy to look after her baby, and you see people walking in the state of a drunken, and they're not drunken, it's a punishment of Allah for them that is so severe in that day. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah says to us in the Quran, فَانْظُرُوا إِلَىٰ أَثَرِ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ كيف يحيي الله كيف يحيي الأرض بعد موتها؟ إن ذلك لمحيي الموتى. Indeed, Allah asked us in Surah Al-Kum, which is a surah that has many ayat that intellectually urges us to reflect on the power of Allah and His creation. And from the ayat that Allah wants us to be reflected on, انظروا إلى رحمة الله أثر رحمة الله. To look over the rahmah, the power of the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Athar rahmatillah. The impact of the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. كيف يحيي الأرض بعد موتها. How He brings life to earth after its death. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. Indeed, there are in this ayat endorsements, proofs that Allah is able to bring life to this. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ And He has the ultimate power. The ultimate power to do whatever He likes. And we see it here as we not live in dry environment. We see it as the weather changes and as the sun comes out and as the snow melts. We see the أثر of رحمة الله عز وجل. The impact of the رحمة. Of Allah in the environment around us. We see the grass turning green after becoming yellow. And we're seeing once again the trees budding out, and we're seeing the trees bringing out leaves, and we see life coming back again after a season of death. This is indeed the rahmah of Allah, certainly. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ And He is indeed able to do whatever He wishes. لَا إِلَهَ وَإِلَهُمْ إِلَهُمْ وَاحِدٍ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمٌ Indeed, your Lord is one. no partner with him, and he is indeed Rahman Rahim. And allow me into this khutbah in a few minutes of time to share with you the concept of Rahmah in the Quran. We are in desperate need for the Rahmah of Allah. The Rahmah that He has created and divided to 100 proportion in the famous hadith that all of us are aware of. He kept 99 Rahmah for Himself to use it for the Ummah in the hereafter. And He sent only one proportion of His Rahmah, 1 of 100 of His Rahmah was sent down. And from that Rahmah, you see the compassion. The compassionate feelings align the creations. You would see it in the relationship between the mother and the child. You would see it in the relationship between the spouses. You would see it in the relationship between people on this earth as they stand up for each other with compassion and rahmah. This is the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So when we look into the meaning of rahmah, linguistically, we will find that rahmah comes in a better way by describing it in the opposite way, by saying rahmah is the opposite of qaswa. To better understand the meaning of rahmah, which means compassion, love and mercy, it should be described better when you say that the opposite of rahmah is cruelty, is hardness of the heart. ثم قست قلوبكم من بعد ذلك فهي كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة. As Allah described certain group that their hearts had become so hard, it is like a rock, and even from the rocks that which is a river will be gushing, and a water will be coming out and will be coming down as dear from the fear of Allah Azza wa Jalla. The opposite of rahmah is qaswa. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam upon one occasion saw his grandchildren and he hugged them and kissed them in front of one of the Bedouins who said to him in surprise, "Do you kiss your children?" The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, "Indeed, yes." And then he said, "I have 10 of the children, I never kissed one of them." He said, "Ma asma' laka, inna za'allahu rahmatan min qalbi." What should I do to you if Allah have taken out the rahmah from your heart? And in countless occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us the rahmah of Allah in his ibad. In one of the stories in which he was once with Abu Bakr and Umar, they were both walking in Medina and they saw a child walking crying by himself. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Umar to bring the child over, and Umar brought him over to comfort him. And then shortly after that, a woman was seen walking in the streets of Medina, so overwhelmed to the point that she forgot to put her hijab on, with tears in her eyes, looking around. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam realized he's looking for this child, and he asked her to be called. And then when she hugged her child with tears, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَمُوْقِيَةٌ هَامِهِ وَلَدَهَا فِي النَّارِ. Would this woman throw her own son into the fire? And then the immediate response, لَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. No, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Indeed, she's so compassionate. And then he illustrated to us that the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal is way and far beyond and bigger than the rahmah of this mother in her own child. This is the rahmah of Allah. Indeed, the mighty Allah Azza wa Jalla have revealed to us a chapter in the Quran that is titled by Ar-Rahman, Allamahu al-Quran, Khalaqa al-Insana Allamahu al-Bayan. Indeed, He illustrated to us His Rahman, as He Himself being Ar-Rahman, and this is where Ar-Rahim came from. As Allah Azza wa Jal created the womb, He called it Ar-Rahim, from Ar-Rahma, and from one of His derivatives, Ar-Rahman. And when Ar-Rahim attacked by the arsh of Ar-Rahman, it's Allah Azza wa Jal said to it, after it said, هذا مقام العائلة. المطيعة منك، ألا يكفيك أن أصل من وصلك وأن أقطع قطعك؟ Are you not content and happy that I only offer the one who looks after you and I disconnect and remote the one who doesn't look after you? This is the rahmah of Allah which works us with society in our life by being so compassionate and rahim to those who are around us, to those who have rahim with us, and those who have are most worthy of our rahim are al-waladayn, the parents. وَقَضَ رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. This is الرحم and الرحمن, the one who علم القرآن and then created an insan to teach us that your Quran is the guidance of رحمة to you. It is needed for you before your creation so that you are able to benefit from this manual of رحمة to you in your life. And if we were to explore the rahmah of Allah in the Quran, there is a beautiful chapter that which we recite every Friday, in which the Allah Azza wa Jal describes to us His rahmah. رَحْمَةً لِلْرَبِّ وَمَا فَعَلْتُهُ عَنْ أَمْرِ ذَلِكَ تَأْوِيلُهَا لَمْ تَصْلَحْ عَلَيْهِ صَبْرًا. هَذَا رَحْمَةٌ لِلْرَبِّكَ فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ الْآخِرَةِ فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ الْآخِرَةِ. This is indeed the rahmah of Allah in preventing Ya'juj and Ma'juj from coming out. And then when the time for Akhira comes, then the walls will be demolished and they will come out. The rahmah of Allah was described in numerous occasions in the Quran. But let's live for a few minutes. Let's live in a few minutes in a story that many of us are familiar with and aware of, which is the first story in that chapter, in which Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ فَقَالُوا. This is a story that all of us are aware of, but let's look at it from a different perspective. Let's look at it from a different dimension, from the dimension of the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. Indeed, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنَّ أَصْحَابَ الْكَهْفِ وَالرَّقِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. You think that the story of the people of the cave is indeed a miracle. مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ. When the youngsters came to the cave, what was the first thing they asked for? Did they ask for a nice dinner or a comfortable mattress to sleep on? Did they ask even for security to be provided to them? They did not ask for any of that. Their only request was the following. Two things they asked for in one of the most difficult and critical moments in their lives, as they were chased to be killed, as they were chased away from their own towns, and then knew that if the soldiers of the king were to capture them, then there's nothing going to be waiting for them except to lose their life. What did they ask Allah for? إِذْ أَوَى الْفِتْيَةُ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ فَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا. Two things that we are in desperate need for in difficult situations. Two things we are in desperate need for in critical moments. The first thing is رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً. Give us from you, Ya Rabbi. They called up Allah, they said, Rabbana, our Rabbi, our Lord, the one who looks after us, the one who cares for us. Ya Rabbi, we're asking you for one thing, to give us your rahmah, Ya Rabbana Alameen. Because if you give us your rahmah, then we are in different environment. We are living with you. فَأُوْ إِلَى الْكَهْفِ يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا. They ask for rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Because the rahmah of Allah, if it showers you, then you could be seen in what looks like in the eyes of those who are around you in difficult conditions. You could be seen in critical circumstances. You could be seen in hardship, but in the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jalla is making you to live in a different world, in a world in which you are looked after by the mighty Allah Azza wa Jalla. يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ. Allah not only will be giving you from His rahmah, but يَنْشُرْ shower you with His rahmah. وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا. And will be facilitating for you from your أمر مِرْفَقًا. All the details, all the necessities, مِرْفَقًا as we know in the Arabic language, الْمَرَافِقْ. The avenues of, and the facilities that you are in need for in your mind, all that will be looked after by Ar-Rahman. فَضَرَبْنَا عَلَىٰ آذَانِهِمْ فِي الْكَهْفِ سِنِينَ عَدَدًا. Allah has just said that. He has ضَرَبْنَا عَلَىٰ آذَانِهِمْ. We disabled their ears, because the only sense that works with you and when you are in the state in the smallest state of death, because when we die, we are dead. And the only sense that is functioning is our ears, our hearing. And that's why when we hear any noise, we wake up. Allah does disable that so that we are able to stay in death for number of for hundreds of years, as we all know, 309 years of time. فَأُوِّ الْكَهْفِ يَنْشُرْ لَكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ وَيُهَيِّئْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَمْرِكُمْ مِرْفَقًا وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ. He made everything. He created, including the sun, the huge star that Allah created, that is far more in size than the size of our earth, let alone the size of one of the creations of Allah Azza wa Jal. The sun was utilized by Allah Azza wa Jal to look after these censers. وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ عَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ. Visits them as it shines from the right. وَتَقْلِدُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ. And visits them as it goes and sits off from the left. وَتَرَى الشَّمْسَ إِذَا طَلَعَتْ تَزَاوَرُ عَنْ كَهْفِهِمْ ذَاتَ الْيَمِينِ. وَإِذَا غَرَبَتْ تَقْرِضُهُمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ وَهُمْ فِي فَجْوَةٍ مِنْ هِلَالِهَا مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَهُوَ الْمُهْتَدِ. It is indeed the hidayah of Allah that we are destined for. That's why they ask Allah Azzal, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً وَهَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. يَا رَبِّي, we are powerless. Ya Rabbi, we are helpless. Ya Rabbi, we do not know what is good for us. Therefore, Ya Rabbi, your guidance is the best. هَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. هَيِّئْ لَنَا مِنْ أَمْرِنَا رَشَدًا. Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Qareeb. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعاني فليستجيبوا وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. In difficult moments, my brothers and sisters, in one of the darkest moments in our life, we are in desperate need for the rahmah of Allah. And second, we are in most desperate need for the rashad of Allah. We don't know. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Therefore, in difficult situations, keep insisting on Allah, the one who said to you, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I am close to them. فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي. I am so close to them that I respond to the dua of the da'i when he asks or she asks me. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي. Let them respond to my call. Let them respond to the call of Allah which initiated to you long time ago. وَلْيُؤْذِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. So that they may be able to achieve the rushd in their life. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. فَلَقُوا سَتَسْتَغْفِرُونَ.